Hello friends, once again welcome back to Excel Home Made Tutorial channel. And if you haven't subscribed my channel so far, so kindly subscribe to my channel to know more a lot about job vacancies, how to apply visa and all that. There are a lot of videos, not only Excel but a lot more topics, so do it now please. Okay, so let's talk about how to use macros in Excel today's topic. So to use macros, you need to go to the View tab. As you can see here on the View tab, you will see the macros. You have three options: View macros, record macro, and use relative reference. So we're going to record macro. You can give any name you want for the macro. You can put any shortcut key. For instance, I'm going to put Control plus K, and you can store the macro anywhere you wish. You have three options: personal macro, new workbook. This program, I'm going to do it for personal macro for now. And you got a description also, that is optional. So when you click OK, so now the recording is started already. You can open another sheet. As you can see, it says ready here, so the recording is working. For double check, you can go to macro again. You will see the new option came, stop recording. So now in this sheet, whatever the data, whatever the form you want to create, you can create, and it's just being recorded. Alright, for instance, I'm gonna make this small table here with the name, ID, salary, deduction and the total pay. So this will be a table which you don't have to type again and again. You can just run macro next time and this will be pasted to the next sheet automatically with the formula, with the data, whichever you want to put right now. So for now, I'm just making this table. Let's enhance it a little bit. Let's change the color. All right, so I can put some names here: ID, salary, deduction and the total pay, and the formula which I want to put here. So for now, I'm gonna put some names like Mohan, Rohan, so on, whatever. The data could be anything, whatever you're going to put. So whatever the form you need to create, you can create in the macro and you can run the macro next time, so you don't have to type all that again. So that's how the macro works in Excel. So the ID number, I'm just putting anything. All right, so and the salary also. For now, I will just show you one or two. So just we'll put some salary, deduction and total pay. But before that, I want to put the formula. So salary and minus deduction, then that will be the total pay for that particular person. Example from his salary, whatever it is, and the deduction, whatever it is, and press enter and drag the formula. Alright, so for now, if I want to put some amount in salary and deduction, so the formula will work automatically, of course. So 1850, yes. And now you can stop the recording, or you can even delete those first and stop the recording. So all this data, whatever I made here, it's already recorded. So now stop recording. Now next, what you need to do is to go to another sheet and click the place where you want the data to be placed, and don't forget to press the shortcut key, which is we set as Control plus K. Right, initially we made the key, the shortcut key. So here you need to press the shortcut key Control plus K. On the next sheet, you will see the macro, the data, whichever the table we created, it will be pasted itself as formula. You can see the sheet 9 has been created next to sheet 8. Sheet 7, we did the macro recording. Now sheet 9, you can see all the data is already there. You just press Control and K. And when I put here any amount, see the formula is also working. So this is how macros works. If you go, you can also go again here, use View macros. You get an option. When you click on run, it will work the same way. Yes, you can see the next sheet, sheet 11 has been created, and on that sheet all the data which we created is still there. Let's try when the formulas are working. So this is how it works. That's all.